in the period, the 30 years, say, or 20 years up to the crash, how much of an outlier was the UK in terms of its industrial policy?
Well, it really depends what you mean by industrial policy, and I think that's where the confusion is. Really, what industrial policy is about having a coherent economic strategy, which is really about thinking of different ways that innovation and productivity can be supported. And it's that which the last 10 years has really been lacking in the UK, both in terms of falling amounts of R&D spending within businesses, also in terms of government-funded R&D, but also in terms of actually having a direction for that change. And it's not about picking winners in terms of particular firms or even narrowly defined sectors. It's really about doing, in some ways, what China's doing today, and also what Germany, Finland, South Korea, and Brazil are doing. Just take China. They've announced $1.5 trillion over the next 5 years in a set of seven different broadly defined sectors, which are new energy cars, new generation IT, energy-saving technologies, high-end equipment manufacturing, new materials. And within those, thinking of the broad range of different policies which can really make China a leader. Finland, Germany, South Korea, the same thing. The UK, in terms of green, it's really a disaster, both in terms of the signals that have, that are constantly changing. So the scandal around the feed-in tariffs, being withdrawn, causing quite a bit of confusion from the private sector.
The solar panel subsidy. But look, let me just put this to you. I mean, you take a country like the United States, which has got Silicon Valley. To what extent could you say, look, successes do occur from non-interventionist policies?
Well, I've actually written a short book about that called The Entrepreneurial State, which basically says that if Europe wants more Googles, Facebooks, and Amazons, which is basically the big question that you keep hearing.
Yeah.
I go to the European Commission all the time, and that's the question they're asking. To learn from Silicon Valley, you have to understand the huge, an absolutely huge amount of state investment that went to build it, both in terms of the IT sector. The obvious example is that the internet was both funded in terms of its early research, but also commercialized by DARPA. But you have a host of about 15 different state agencies in the U.S., which include the National Science Foundation, the Small Business Innovation Research, DARPA, and a set of different ones which really understand what public policy is about, which is actually doing what the private sector is not willing to do, because I think there's too much confidence in the UK that business investment is just going to pour in, for example, to green tech. What we learned from Silicon Valley is that the early stage of IT, the early stage of biotech, the early stage of nanotech actually had very courageous, bold government funding,
right,
kicking off those sectors. And the private sector came in much later, especially, by the way, private venture capital is notorious for coming in something like 15 to 20 years after huge amounts of state investment in particular early, high-risk, high-uncertainty sectors.
To what extent do you accept what Mariana Mazzucato has just been telling us, that essentially the era of waiting for the market to deliver an industrial structure that works, that era is probably gone now, that there's an acceptance we have to, there needs to be some government steerage?
I think that's absolutely right. I think the analysis was spot on. And if we talk narrowly about manufacturing, because industry policy goes faster than manufacturing, we've had a decade in which manufacturing declined more rapidly in the UK than anywhere else in the developed world, partly an exchange rate issue, but I think more generally an over-reliance on banking. And I think we now accept, as you've just heard, that government does have a role. It isn't sort of splashing around vast quantities of money, but getting behind the successful sectors, and automotive industry is one of them, aerospace, creative industries, low carbon, supporting innovation. We have a limited budget, but we're now doing that with our technology centre, so-called catapults, supporting training, apprenticeships, and backing supply chains, which have been hollowed out in the past in the UK.